McCready! McCready! Just... Fine, you want to take him on hand to hand, that's your issue.
Well, they're not going to need that stuff
whatever,
anymore.
Man, just whatever. Is there a way I can get around here? I don't want to go through all the super mutants, that's the problem. No, it doesn't look like I can get through there. Okay, I'm gonna have to go around. So yeah, computer games aren't the only thing that PAX has to offer. They also, have like an entire tabletop section where you can sort of, experiment with and mess around with and purchase, various sorts of tabletop games, board games, card games, you know, role-playing games, stuff like, you know, the classics like Dungeons & Dragons and Call of Cthulhu and Shadowrun type stuff, as well as, like...
Why is that name so familiar? I heard it back in the Capital Wasteland, but I can't remember why.
What are you babbling about? I'm trying to talk here, McCready. Yeah, so, and there's, like, the other ones, like, you know, Settlers of Catan and Munchkin and all the, all the various, like, board games and card games and stuff, that you can play. There's tons and tons and tons of them, and I have a passing interest in that kind of stuff, right now, I guess, because, you know, when I was at university, I was actually part of a gaming club, and we did have, like, regular games of Dungeons & Dragons and stuff. But I haven't done any of that, anything like that in years, so I guess my interest in that kind of stuff is really only for nostalgia reasons. I don't actually have an active gaming group that I'm a part of right now, so, you know, I'm not, like, actively interested in it. At this moment, so, you know, oh no, it's a Minuteman, it's okay, he's just a Minuteman, I don't need to fight him, so yeah, my interest in, what they have on offer is going to be, you know, very narrow, and a lot of the stuff is just going to be, kind of meh to me. I'm just gonna be like, yeah, whatever, it's kind of interesting and everything, but, it's not something I'm really psyched for, so, you know, that's why I don't really bother, or I have not bothered in previous years to go to PAX, but you know, this year, because, you know, I had a friend and offering me a free pass, I thought, why not. Okay, so let's, ooh, you've got more mines, good on you. You guys know the score. Plasma cartridge. I don't know if I'm gonna need the grenades, but whatever. All right, let's do this first.
Hi, everyone's here, General. There it is. Pretty impressive, huh? Its real name is Fort Independence, but the Minutemen always just called it the castle. Now you can see why I wanted to take it back.
Oh yeah.
Maybe. Those walls could definitely use some work.
I'll admit, it's seen better days, but the Minutemen have never been afraid of hard work. Our primary objective is to clear the courtyard. That's where we should see the most opposition. The wall on this side is the most exposed, but if we circle around south, we could also reach the main gate.
What are we waiting for? Let's just get in there and shoot those lobsters.
No, if we split up, we can flank them from both sides. It'll be like shooting fish in a barrel.
Why not let them come to us? We set up a firing line on this side, and you can draw them out.
Well, General, what do you think?
Yeah, I don't think you guys will survive if you go running in there, so let's just do this one.
Set up a firing line, and I'll draw them out.
Sure, whatever. Better you than me.
Oh.
Sounds good. We'll hold back and wait for them to come to us. Just don't get yourself trapped in there. All right, people. You heard the General. Let's move on.
Yeah, you heard me.
Try not to draw their attention until we're in position.
But, McCready, I fully expect you to come in with me. You're gonna help me draw them out. Come on. Don't be a slacker. Oh, jeez. This McCready guy. Alright, so yeah, this is gonna be interesting. I'm not quite sure. Not quite sure how to do this. I think it's fairly safe.
This must have been one heck of a circus when the Minutemen were
I think
in
it's
town.
Fairly safe for the moment to just go ahead and take this route and fight them from this side. So, let's just stick with the plan as is for the moment.
Mole rats of the sea.
Wonder how much ammo do I have?
What they did to this place?
Yeah, I'm gonna have to kind of deal with this.
I swear I heard something.
Got company. MacReady.
That's what I call a confirmed kill.
Playtime's over!
What a waste of time.
Pretty sure I don't even need
alone.
To use vats. These guys are a piece of cake. Piece of Mirelurk cake. Mmm. Yum, yum, yum. Oh, wow, you're all charging in now? Okay. Uh-oh. Okay, you guys deal with that. I have stuff to do. So here's the deal. In a moment, this is going to become ground zero for the craziest fight I have ever seen anywhere ever. So I am going to prepare a little bit by dropping every single mine I have over here. Pulse mine. I don't know what that guy is talking about. Yeah, he's just making plans and I'm just going to ignore him. Because this is more important. This is more important, Preston.
Let's go kick some shell.
Destroy the egg clutches. You think that's enough? All right, let's go. Come on, guys. Away from there. Get away. Get away. Get away from that location. I kind of want to take the eggs. Ah! Oh no! They're attacking me! What the hell is that? This is interesting. Bats angle. Oh come on! What's going on here? I do want the Mirelurk eggs, though. Mirelurk meat?
We're splitting all that.
Yes, we will split the Mirelurk eggs. Trust me. Trust me, MacReady. I know what I'm doing. Oh, crap. This place is full. Whoa. Hello. Yeah, just Minutemen. Whatever. Yep, and we have Mirelurks, of course. Mm-hmm. Why are they just coming out one at a time? Come on.
Here we go.
Wow. Not the leg. Ooh, there's another one. These angles, it's so bizarre.
Wait, let's do this.
Something's out there.
No, don't run over there.
Sure, run.
Don't run over there. It's a trap.
What was that?
Hold up.
Stay away. Is it coming?
It's a far cry from working with the gunners. Glad that's behind me.
This guy is gonna get himself killed. Don't stand there. I guess we just have to accept the fact that we're not gonna get any eggs out of this, cause... Oh! Oh! I should have totally targeted the other one. I accidentally... I'm taking damage, getting rads, I'm gonna get parasites or something out of this, I'm sure. But hey, look, eggs.
What the hell was that?
There we go. Dude, no, stay away. Stay away.
Damn it, where are you? Found you.
Stay away. Do you think it's dead? Oh, look, there's another Mirelurk. Oh, I can't even hit it from here. Well, you know.
I think we have company.
I think we're done. That was...
All right. Good work, people. But we aren't done yet.
We're not?
The General and I are going to have a look at the radio to see what shape it's in. The rest of you. Clear out any remaining Mirelurks or eggs you find.
Damn, I hate these things.
Yeah, I hate them too, man. So yeah, that was actually kind of anticlimactic. I didn't even get to see it explode, but apparently, apparently when you drop a bunch of mines here, it doesn't get very far before it just absolutely gets obliterated. Now, where did it? Did it float off somewhere? The body? I don't even know. It's... Is it worth looking for? It's a Mirelurk queen, but I guess, eh, whatever. Whatever. I don't really care. So yeah, that's kind of done now, I guess. There are, of course, eggs and things that we need to clear out. Whoa. Whoa. Why are you not killing these things, guys? What am I paying you for? Ooh, you know, the novelty of having super slow motion vats is starting to wear off a little. Whoa, legendary glowing Mirelurk. No! No, the Minutemen are in trouble! No! Save the Minutemen! Oh boy. That could have gone horribly, horribly wrong. I feel ill, insomnia, now? Now all of a sudden I get insomnia. Okay, so he's pretty healthy actually, so... I didn't really need to worry.
I knew it!
I had no choice.
Mm-hmm. So what is this? Armored skirt? I have an armored skirt. Wow, I've never seen that before. What is an armored skirt? That's so bizarre. Okay, what's this? These... Whoop. They're edible? How do I... Whatever. I need a shotgun or something to just to clear out all these little things in one hit, one shell, rather than having to waste all my ammunition on each of these things individually. That would probably be beneficial. That would be helpful. That's one thing I didn't think of. But, whatever. I'm getting plenty of eggs here, so I have breakfast for days. Breakfast for days.
That's the steak you'll ever make.
Ooh. But yeah, I was saying that, you know, it was initially quite cool that Vats was in, like, slow motion, because you get to see, like, all the slow motion shots. It feels like you're in the Matrix. It's really cool and everything. But then, all of a sudden, it just starts to get old. It's like, come on, speed things up. I'm in a hurry here, yet. You're taking your time with these slow motion shots. It's really annoying. But, whatever. I'm sure there's a mod somewhere you can get, which is like, accelerated VATS. Or something like that, where it just gets, it goes back to normal speed or something. I don't know. I wonder if there is a mod that does that. What would surprise me? There's mods for everything in this game. Is that everything? Have we done the walls? I think the walls are done. Although somebody's still shooting at something. Suppose we go inside? Huh? Is that where this is? Too many Mirelurks in here. Uh-oh. Run away, little hatchlings! I am killing you! Killing you all! I feel like a genocidal maniac just slaughtering. Oh, I'm carrying too many Mirelurk eggs. This is not good. What are we gonna do? I can't drop the eggs. Surely not. Maybe the grenades. I don't really need the grenades. Is there somewhere I can put these? In here. But have a bunch of grenades. Oh, I probably don't want to put all of them in there. Let's take a few. What else have we got? We got armor stuff, but Seriously, what is it that's weighing me down? Is it the eggs? Are they that heavy? Wow, they weigh one each. Wow. Okay, they are kind of heavy. Let's just put them in there. Oh, jeez. I can't believe I carried that many Mirelurk eggs and ran out of inventory space. That's just so typical of me. But yeah, so, you know, I did have fun at VATS. At PAX. That's the one. It was certainly entertaining. But as I said, I wasn't that interested in a lot of the games and stuff that they had on offer, and I wasn't keen on sitting around, standing around in queues, because, like, all the cool stuff, like the VR trials and things, the stuff that you could try out, had, like, really long queues. You'd be standing around for hours in a queue to
I'm looking for while we're here is one of those funny looking hats.
To just try out for a brief moment a VR headset with like a treadmill thing that you can walk on. Who is still shooting, and what are they shooting at? Anyway, oh, you're already gone to sleep. Sure, there's still combat going on and everything, but hey, you gotta sleep, you gotta sleep, I guess. So, you know, I wasn't gonna do that, And the stuff that they have on sale, it's not cheap or anything. It's just normal retail prices, as far as I can tell. So it doesn't seem like any reason for me to buy stuff while I'm there either. So I guess I spent most of my time at VATS. I spent most of my time at PAX going around and doing like sitting in all the panels and the seminars and the talks that they do, because they have like these panels where they get like a bunch of people, developers and game creators and people in the industry, hardware, software, whatever, and they talk about various stuff. And not just computer games either. Like they had a bunch where there were people in the tabletop gaming industry talking about different stuff, and you know, those were pretty interesting and entertaining, I guess. But I'm not sure. Where is this other guy?
I guess it could be worse.
What are you shooting at? What is it? I honestly don't know what this guy is shooting at. This is so weird. There's a hatchling up there, but what is this guy shooting at?
Let's trade some things.
Sure.
Just start trading with him. Look, there's nothing here. Oh, I probably shouldn't be wasting the ammo, actually. That's gonna get really annoying if he's just gonna stand there shooting constantly. Where's the one that was up here? Okay. Yeah, hatchling. Is that the only one? Nope, there's a bunch. Wow, okay. So yeah, you know, I was just going from panel to panel and sitting in and chilling out and listening to these people talking about various stuff from the gaming industry. And that was pretty interesting, but I'm not sure that that is in and of itself necessarily worth the cost of the tickets, because you know, it's not cheap buying a pass for PAX. I mean, even just the 1 day passes aren't really all that cheap, and I'm not sure I will necessarily be interested in going next year, because yeah, I don't know. It just doesn't seem like it's worth the time and the money. You're done? You're finished? You finished shooting a pile of dirt? Is that it? Okay. Alright, he's done. I don't know what he was trying to do, but okay. I guess we have to go activate this thing, right? We have to activate this. We've got food and water shortages, and we need power and defense, and then we need to do that. Wow, yeah, that's gonna be interesting. I don't know. I don't know. But yeah, I guess. Yeah, I was just checking the time to see where I am on time for this episode. Yeah, it seems like I've got a little bit more time, so I guess we may as well start setting things up. I don't know what I've actually got in terms of equipment here, whether or not I can actually build a generator. I can. How many can I build? It doesn't tell me. I've got one. It's just, what, sitting in stock? And I've got two small ones sitting in stock? Where did these come from? Don't look a gift horse in the mouth, I guess, but... Yeah. Oh. No, it wasn't in stock. I did have to build that. What is going on? That's weird. Whatever. But I need water and stuff as well. Oh, no, there's a water filtration thing over there. I just need to power it. What about food? Food. What have I got in terms of food? Nothing. Okay. I totally forgot to bring crops over. Alright. So what do we need to power this? We need 10. And then... So we need to get power to that, and then that will power all the lights. And then what? And then what? What happens? There's also a thing out here, right? Yeah, there's that thing, but I don't know how much power it needs. How much power does this thing need? I don't know. And I don't want to jump down there to find out. So, let's just start building more generators and see how we go. I'm definitely going to need at least one more. What do I need? I need steel. And I have enough rubber and screws and ceramic. Yeah, okay. There should be plenty of steel around. All I need to do is start scrapping stuff, right? Well, obviously not that, but... there's gotta be things lying around in here. Come on. Yeah, okay, so look, we've got a cooking stove, but I don't really want to scrap that, actually. But the cans, you can scrap those. And that, I guess. Can. Actually, you should probably, here's just like a little bit of advice. For anybody, whenever you get like a blue ore around something, you're better off probably just storing it. And the yellow ore stuff, so that those can only be scrapped. But if you see like a blue ore around something, even if it is like a junk item that you want to use, use the store option, and that will just go into the workshop. The workbench. And it will. It will just sit there as a... Oh, I can actually pick this up. It'll sit there as, you know, a usable item if you need it. But it'll stay, like, in its complete form. It won't turn into its component parts, which is kind of handy in case you ever need, like, whole objects for things. Because occasionally, you know, certain recipes or whatever, crafting recipes will require you to have like a complete whole object of something. Although I'm not sure about the shelving. That's... Yeah, because it's not a junk item, I think. Shelving will not be usable for its component parts unless you actually like properly scrap it. But because this is like proper shelving that isn't broken or anything, I might just leave that there. I think we've got enough to build the other or another generator. But I'm not... I don't know. Again, I don't know how much power that thing out there takes. I'm kind of inclined to build... I'm kind of inclined to build a large one, or maybe like a nuclear reactor or something, because that will probably be more efficient with my supplies. I probably shouldn't have built that that medium one, but you know, what's done is done. We have a medium generator, whatever. Steel and wood. Wow. Barrels are so useful. I'm not sure I'm going to use all this wood, though. Okay. I think we're probably good. I don't really care too much about like getting this settlement done properly. See, I can't even tell how much. It doesn't tell me what component parts I need for this thing. Is it just me, or is this busted? Is this wrong? What do I need for this? I need aluminium. I don't have aluminium. Okay, fine. We'll build another one of these. And I can build another one as well? Oh, okay. It doesn't tell me how many component parts what component parts I need for that. It's really annoying. Look, let's just power that up. And, let's just run a cable over here. Very low cable, don't trip on it. Oh, wow, we have 40 water all of a sudden. Is this a thing? Oh no, okay, so it's prioritizing, okay. So how much does that thing take then? I wish I knew. I should run out there and have a look. Can I? No, I can't. I can't sprint. How much? It requires 5 power. Okay, so we're going to need another generator. At least. I should probably... This is like a complete waste of component parts and stuff, but can I even build another one? I can. This is good. Alright. Ta-da! And let's just hook that one up as well. And no, it's still not powered. Wow, seriously. We're out of screws. I guess we can just put like a small one in. This kind of sucks the way we're doing this, but yeah, I'm not in any mood to be properly. What? Come on, we have 18 power. This requires 10. The thing out there requires 5. Is there something else that is chewing up all the power in here? I don't think the lights... What are they? Lights? No, they don't require specific amounts. What's happening? I don't know what's going on. Oh, okay. I'm an idiot. Okay, so it's because I haven't... There we go. Alright. Fine.
Excellent. Comics report. Stay safe, people.
You're a comic book fan,
I love comics.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So we have a radio station up and running. That's cool, I guess. I think Preston also wants to have a chat with us, and you know, it's pretty much almost time to finish up the episode, so...
Wow, we really did it. I've been watching the Minutemen fall to pieces for so long, this is really something. Now we've got to pay off on what we've started, bring the whole Commonwealth together, and make it last this time. So, you know, back to business. But with Radio Freedom up and running, we can broadcast alerts to you anywhere, anytime.
Anywhere?
I'll let you know if I hear of any settlements that need our
anytime.
Help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it. That can only help our cause.
Okay. What else do we need around here? Do we have enough beds? We've got 5 beds, 3 people, 40 water. We got 0 defense, 0 food. Okay, so this is a bit of a problem. We're going to have to we're gonna have to find some kind of way to supply this place. I don't know. I'm gonna have to run around and actually pick up supplies. Or maybe I'll just like set up a supply line. That might help. You know, those things that connect my settlements and allow me to... Ooh, wow, screws galore. I should have scrapped these things from the beginning. Jeez. Oh man, that would have allowed me to build properly large reactors and stuff. But yeah, all right, so that's probably going to be it for me for today. This will be I think probably 2 episodes long, doing all this and getting things together and sorting myself out and clearing this place. But now that we've got this all done and we can start setting up defenses and probably building this place, which I'll probably do a little bit of because the castle becomes relevant later on in the Minutemen storyline, to my knowledge anyway. So I probably will spend a little bit of time properly sorting this place out and making sure it's all hunky-dory. But in the meantime, I think... What have we got? We've got the Battle of Bunker Hill to go to, and we got settlements and stuff to set up. But I don't know. How many settlements do I have? I've got a lot, but I don't know how many of them are actually populated. So I'm going to have to work all that out and figure out what I need to do things to progress this for the Minutemen and, back their cause and everything. But once I figure that out, I will continue on. So yeah, thanks for watching. And as always, if you like the content, then subscribe and... And I will be posting more videos within a week. Feel free to comment and give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And I will see you guys in the next video.